Hugh Hunt is an engineer at Trinity College, University of Cambridge. Matt Parker is a guy from YouTube who talks about maths. Together, Matt and Hugh play with a thing and then do some working out. Okay, this time, in a change of pace, I have brought a thing to play with. So this is my Euler disk that I did a video on recently, where I tried to calculate the rate that, the rate at which the disk rotates compared to the rate at which it wobbles.
And you've got an arrow
I've
on your...
I've got an arrow on my disk.
Well...
Of course. You've got...
I have an oil.
You've got your own oil... Oh, you've got the psychedelic attachment.
Yeah.
Look at that. You've got your own arrow that you put on there for the same reason.
Absolutely.
So you were also trying to work out the different rates.
Why do you spin yours that way? Why do you spin yours that? God, it's harder.
Like what?
Well, I go that way.
Oh my goodness. Should we have a race? No, there's no. Okay. Later on, we will have a race. Right. So, or a competition. We'll see who goes the longest. So what did you find with yours?
This is a discotheque.
It is a disc. Well done. Congratulations.
Sorry.
That's not going to make it in the edit. Anyway, so how did I do? You've seen the video.
Brilliant. The thing that's...
The brilliant was clearly at the end of the sentence,
The edit was beautiful.
Thank you.
As it slowed down and you're doing the maths, that's great.
Thank you.
But if you want to do measurements, you can't do measurements as it's slowing down because the angle's always changing and the rate's always speeding up.
Okay, it's not ideal, but...
What you really want is for the angle to stay constant. So that over time,
in
with
a perfect
stopwatch...
world, yes. Then you can sample over a longer period of time because it's not changing. Yeah.
In the engineering department, I've got a little rig which does just that.
No way.
Yeah.
Okay, so what on earth have we got?
Well, Matt, look, when you've got your Euler disk running like this...
Okay.
It's fine, you see the dot moving around, everything works fine, but it stops. And if you actually want to make measurements, then...
You've got to be quick, because
it's
spinning down.
It'd be nice to have it going in what I'd call steady state.
Right, so it never stops.
So it never stops, and I can do that with...
Oh my goodness.
Air jets. And what I got here is...
So you've got...
Four jets of air. And this thing will run forever.
That's never going to stop.
Never going to stop. I've got to get the air jets kind of pointing in the right direction.
Okay.
So that it doesn't screw up like it just did, but that should be fine now. And what I can do is I can use this vernier here.
So that tells you exactly how...
So as I go down, which I'm doing here, eventually it will start to...
It'll
bump onto it, and you can see it bumping.
There you go.
I've overdid it a bit.
Okay, you overdid it. So hang on, why is it going forever? Is it just giving it a bump?
It's really neat, because this air jet here, this air jet is blowing over the top of the disc, which pushes it down.
Right.
And then here,
and then that one, now pushes it up.
And then over here, it's not doing anything.
Oh my goodness.
So
and then,
this one gives it a push, then this one. Then this one.
Then that one, and then repeat.
And I can make it go faster or slower. Now, what's really neat as well is that this infrared sensor has a little transmitter and a receiver.
Okay.
Which reflects a beam of light off the disc.
You're kidding me.
That beam of light is...
So that's logging.
That beam of light is... producing a pulse.
So that's each time the disc comes by it.
Yeah, so if I tip this away, it'll start.
Okay, back.
Yep. And then over here, I'm counting, doing the frequency.
Right.
And that tells me it's 5.1 hertz right now.
So we know that's going at exactly 5.1 hertz.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is lovely.
The term over-engineered has been used more than once to describe you, but this is ridiculous.
Well, it's not that ridiculous. It's just what we do. And so long as this thing is pulsing away, I know that that's going to give
you
good reading.
You know that's giving you the frequency.
Yep.
So there's your wobble right there.
Yeah. So now what we can do is...
There's a tenth of a hertz.
Right. So now what we can do with the stopwatch... Okay, ready, set, go. One, two, three, the yellow dot. Four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. So it took 12.4 seconds to do 10 revolutions. So the frequency, there's my pencil gone. So that frequency.
So
I've,
here we go.
So I've got this, it was 5.1 hertz.
Yeah.
The turning rate, which I'm going to call beta dot.
Okay. Beta dot, okay.
Was, so it's 12.4 seconds to 10, so 1.24.
24.
So it's 1 over 1.24, isn't it? Because it's, so 1.24 reciprocal, that's 0.81 hertz. Okay. So it's wobbling at 5.1 hertz, it's turning at 8.1 hertz, okay?
Yep.
Now I need to know the angle.
Right.
Because then I want to check if the ratio works out.
You want to make sure that ratio matches.
Okay, so to get the angle, I take this down. This is only going to be approximate, but it'll give me an answer.
Okay, and wait for it to hit that.
That gives me the height, roughly.
Right.
Which is, so what's that height
okay,
there?
Okay, hang on a second. The height is around about, it's 1184.
28 degrees.
28 degrees.
Now, right, so now
it's still
I
going.
Do, the great thing I can do is, I can lower this.
Or you can slow it down. Pop less air in, it's dropped down a bit. So you can adjust which part of the spin down it stops at.
Yeah.
Right, so we're back and here is our results from the engineering lab, and Hugh has walked away again.
I have walked away, I'm always walking away.
What are you searching for now?
I'm searching for...
He was searching for a thing. Let's find out. So, we got a blank disc.
I got a blank disc. The reason I like my blank disc is that it makes it nice and easy to
draw a circle.
Draw a circle on it, right?
Yeah.
And the idea is that so this little dot here, when it's wobbling like this, you can see that that dot is tracing out a smaller circle.
Yes.
So that smaller circle is where that dot, the edge of the disc is following that. So the dot is moved from there
to there.
To there.
Yep.
And let's call that angle beta. Okay. And that's the turning rate.
So that's okay, so that's
so the turning rate. The Turing rate.
The Turing rate.
That's a Freudian slip. The turning, I'll do it again.
Some rate.
The rate is beta
dot.
Dot.
Oh, okay, right. Okay, right.
Okay. Now, the disc is at some angle.
Which I had as theta.
Which you have as theta. And the wobble rate, that's the rate that, that's the wobble rate.
Right, yeah.
You call that omega.
Yes.
And you worked out that beta dot over omega was 1 over cos theta minus 1.
1, yes. Yeah.
Now.
I was quite proud of that, to be honest.
And it's a brilliant formula.
Thank you.
It's been known for over 100 years.
I worked it out myself.
You did. And it's a great formula. Now, what we can do is to see if it works.
See if it works. Yeah.
So what we measured was theta was 28.2 degrees, 0.81 hertz was 5.1 hertz. Beta dot over omega, we worked that out as 0.16.
Yes.
But then if I do 1 over cos theta minus 1, that came out as 0.13.
And how, I mean, from your experimental professional opinion, how bad or good, I mean?
That's brilliant.
That's good.
I'll tell you why that's brilliant, is because experiments are pretty hard to do.
Tell me about it.
Yeah, that's why you do maths.
Yeah, exactly. Keep my hands clean.
That's why I got people like you.
It's brilliant. What you would want to do is lots of measurements, because ideally you'd want to produce some kind of graph. You would do...
Have a good plot.
Over omega, yeah.
versus
theta.
Theta.
Okay. And you expect it, well, beta dot as omega...
How do you plot? What's a sec minus one? Come on.
What is it?
I don't know.
So we know that as the angle comes down, it wobbles faster and faster and faster, but this slows down.
Yeah.
Okay. It's going to go down through here, and it's going to, I don't know, is it going to do something like this? I don't know.
That's a good guess.
That's a good guess.
Believe me, someone will work it out. And
yeah, someone will work it out.
Comments.
And then what we want is...
And then our noisy data. Okay.
And error bars.
Oh, we do love a good error
bar. Okay, we do love our error. So my guess is that our experiment...
That is well within...
Yeah. Now, we do have another data point.
We do too.
Yeah. So I'm going to do the other one down here. Let's just see how that worked, because we did theta 0.4 hertz, came out to be 0.056. Now, you know what?
Adequate?
Very adequate. All I'm saying really is that... This is telling us that all sorts of things in the maths look right.
Yes.
But I'm afraid, Matt, that the maths doesn't... Just because it's maths doesn't mean it's right.
It's correct.
The maths is correct, but the real world...
Reality, yeah,
okay,
real world.
So what are the things we've got to think about?
Air resistance.
Slipping.
Yeah.
You know, when you're doing a measurement...
That's the messiness.
That's the messiness. And experimental error. But you've got to bear in mind that the error bars are not just about experimental error. The model you might have is...
It could be wrong.
Could be wrong.
But it's close enough to indicate we're moving in the right direction.
One of the things I like about this is that when you do the maths and think about how gravity affects things...
Yes.
Turns out that this wobbling rate
it
would be higher on a planet with higher gravity. You can simulate that by pushing down.
Increasing gravity.
Here we go.
You're going to get the dot on your table. Okay, that's disturbingly good fun. Hang on, wait.
It's easy. Because there's a hole in the middle. Yeah. Tack it off. So you've got to be able to show that it's not...
That is so cool.
And so it turns out there is you can do the math on it using Euler's equations, right?
Yep.
And that gives you that this thing, it turns out to be...
2 root...
And R is the radius of the disk.
Okay, which is pretty constant.
Well, what it... Yeah, R is the radius.
Yeah, yeah.
And G is constant. So that tells you that as the angle gets less, the wobbling rate... gets bigger.
Lovely.
And then when you put this into your 1 over cos theta formula and you do a small theta approximation, you get this beta dot is equal to root g theta cubed over r. And this tells you that as theta goes to 0, beta dot goes to 0.
Okay. And that's what happens.
That's what happens. But what's beautiful about this is that these equations come from basically Newton's laws of motion, and Euler then took them into a beautiful formulation, which is why we call it Euler's Disk.
And so, yeah, so the name makes sense.
The name makes sense, it's a great tribute to Euler. I mean, Euler didn't do much else.
Thank goodness something is finally named after Euler.
Euler's just...
Poor guy, nearly forgotten.
Yeah.
Okay, I think the one thing we have to finish with, people will complain if we don't have an Euler's Disk spin-off. So shall we spin them both at once and see whose goes for the longest?
Okay.
So let's, okay, you position them there. Let's make sure they're perfectly in shot. Okay.
So if this is a race.
It's a marathon. It's an endurance race to see who can go the longest. Okay. Okay.
Is this like Cheltenham? So we are disc jockeys.
We are disc... Oh, for crying out loud. Yes, we are disc jockeys, Hugh. All right, so are you going to go...
I'll do it right up there, okay?
I go anti-clockwise. What are you?
You're normal, I'll do my normal. Okay, 3, 2, 1, go. You started up higher than I did.
Yes, professional.
That's cheating.
It's not cheating. We're spinning the discs and see who goes. Cheating would be bumping the thing. Don't, no. This guy's going to block it with your thing. We got this. We got this. Do you reckon they're going to synchronize? Oh, I've got a little bit of... Are they coupled? I mean, I don't want to declare a winner this early on. This may be the most exciting footage ever dedicated to YouTube. Here we go, ready? You've got a definite...
Oh, I've got a little clunk.
Yeah, what's that?
I think there must be a little... Yeah, I've got a piece of gunk on
my... Something is, yeah. But it's still going to the distance. Here we go. And the winner is...
Yeah, but you cheated. You
cheat. Hang on. Here we go. And... Done.